Welcome to our holiday show. I know you're going to be happy you came cruising with us today. The first thing I want to say is I hate being up here on stage by myself, so therefore the flashlight and the note cards. We need to thank the City of Fort Collins and the Fort Collins Senior Center for providing the time and the space that allows us to put these productions on. Okay. And Ashley Roofer has always been a very, very big fan of ours and our strongest supporter. When she had the opportunity to expand her department, she added a mini Ashley, who is actually Malia Schilling, and she does just as fabulous of a job as Ashley has always done for us. Some people, being slow learners that they are, and I'm talking about Joan, who decided to direct our show for a second time. She has proved quite capable still in wrangling our herd. She also managed to get her daughter to help us a second time with all of our technical lights and sound system, and we very, very much appreciate Jean. And I need to let you know that every single one of us on stage has contributed in some form to the writing of the script. It's not just, you know, a few people that dictate what we're going to do. Then please silence your phones, and you're welcome to take pictures, but no flashes, please. A 15-minute intermission will be between acts 1 and 2. There's a snack bar in the back where you can wet your whistle and grab some grub. And then also at the end of the show is a holiday sing-along with familiar traditional Christmas songs. Please, please join in the sing-along with us at the end. Let the show begin.
This is going to be an interesting cruise by the look of the passengers.
What do you mean?
Well, there's more women on the ship than there are men. So the men are going to have to fend for themselves.
Well, I'll see that doesn't happen.
Okay, see that you do. I'm very excited, though, for this cruise. Madame Fufu is performing during our voyage. I just hope we are ready for all her adoring fans. This is also the first time we've done a senior cruise to nowhere.
Well, you don't worry about a thing. I've got it all under control, sir.
Did you feel the ship move? Oh, I hope I have enough Dramamine for this cruise.
Hi.
Your name and boarding pass, please.
Here are our tickets. I'm Sandra Sills.
And I'm Gretchen Gates.
And I'm Linda Fox.
You are on promenade deck in staterooms 301, 302, and 303.
We're right together.
Your bags have been delivered to your cabins. Do you have any questions?
I have a question. Are there any single men on this cruise?
Yeah.
And how many single men are there? And are any of them good looking? And do any of them have their own hair?
What I want to know is, do they have their own original parts?
All their parts.
Hips, knees, and teeth.
Oh, dear ladies, I don't think those are appropriate questions.
Oh, Gretchen.
Well, I don't know the answers to all those questions, but there are a few men who can walk without any help.
Oh, that is a plus. Let's go find our room.
Yeah, let's find our rooms.
Hi, ladies. By the same.
By the... Are you okay? You should be more careful. A cruise ship is no place for clumsy or hapless behavior.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm just fine. Wow, I made it. You know, it took me 6 flights to get here from home, and I had to transfer 3 times on 2 different airlines. I wonder if my luggage made it. So I put an app on my phone to keep track of wherever it is. And right now my app says it's in Mount Everest.
Well, that's too bad. Maybe you can find something in one of our boutiques.
Oh, no, no, no. I come prepared. See?
Your name and boarding pass, please.
My name is Maladroit. Claude Maladroit. And I was wondering if you had the following activities on board. Do you have bungee jumping, zip lining, rock climbing, paintball, scuba diving lessons, line dancing, cooking class, ping pong, shuffleboard, darts, axe throwing?
We do have all those and more. I hope you have the energy to do them all. Make sure you sign this liability waiver. You are on deck one, just below us, in cabin 101. Please watch out for suitcases in the hall. Enjoy your cruise. Oh, Madame Fufu, it is a pleasure to welcome you to aboard our ship. You are in the penthouse suite on the Lido deck. Your entourage has already delivered luggage to your rooms. I am so looking forward to you performing.
Of course you are. To witness my art is a life-changing event. You will be glad you were here to experience such greatness. Oh, there you are.
Oh, sir, it looks like that's the last of the passengers.
Hey,
oh, there's always latecomers. Why can't they be on time?
I'm not going to miss another chance at seeing him.
Well, it ain't my fault we were caught by your daddy behind his barn drinking his shine in 63.
Jonah was. It was your dang fool idea.
Well, you can just kiss my grits.
Knock me down and steal my teeth.
Well, how am I going to do that? You lost them last week.
But I found them, and I got a spare.
Well, let's get moving.
We don't want to miss this here.
Quickly now, we have
unpacking to do. So let's get moving. Okay, we're on here.
I'm so glad you're in time, ladies.
Me too.
May I have your boarding pass, please?
Sir.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. You are on deck 4, room 402.
Nice.
Enjoy the cruise, I must be leaving you. I am needed on the bridge.
Okay. You know what? Well, butter my butt and call me a biscuit, but I think I saw Mary Sue from high school just leave there.
You know, you can be nuttier than a fruitcake, Franny, but I do think that looks like her.
I know it is.
Let's go.
We're
going
to see. Yeah, we are. We're going to find her.
All passengers, please go to your designated lifeboat stations to learn where to find your life vest and how to use them. A crew member will check you in. Nothing else can happen until the safety drill is completed. Go now.
How do I find my life vest? I can't even find my room.
Just hope we don't get hit by an iceberg.
We're in tropical waters. I think we're safe. Is that Elvis?
Where?
Alrighty, let me see. Ellie Mae Parks. Ellie Mae Parks.
Okay.
Here. All right. Mr. Maladroit.
I don't see him.
Mr. Maladroit. Mr. Claude Maladroit. Ugh. Not present. All right. Franny Lou Harper.
Hi, y'all.
All right. Let's see.
Oh,
refuse to wear that ugly thing. It will crush my dress. And besides, I never wear that color.
Don't touch that! Watch out! I'm coming! Well, Lifeboat 13, that's my lucky number.
Mr. Maladroit.
Here.
Have you had any luck finding your clothing?
Oh, yes, as a matter of fact, I have. My tracker says that my luggage is in Brazil.
All accounted for on lifeboat number 13. Please listen as I explain how to use your life vest. A crew member will demonstrate. First, you take the life vest and put it around your neck, securing it with the strap. You'll notice that there is a whistle attached. This is in case you fall out of the lifeboat. Blow the whistle, and we will be able to locate you. There's also a beacon attached, Mr. Maladroit.
Thank you, Mr. Maladroit. Enough with the whistle. We know where you're at.
Okay. Please follow me.
Yeah, let's get it.
Okay. Oh, I can't hear it.
Well, my father often told me when I was just a lad, a sailor's life is very hard, the food is always bad, but now I've joined the Navy, I'm aboard a man of war, and now I'll find a...
Ladies, I said, please follow me!
Don't climb up the mast, and if you see a sailing ship, it might meet your last, just get your cities ready for another run ashore, a sailor ain't a sailor, ain't a sailor anymore, well, the kilk of our mess.
You know, for a place so full of germs and pestilence and garbage, Mrs. Germain, the sea sure is a beautiful place, isn't it?
Well, it is, but it's oh so treacherous!
I got a question for you. What if a bottlenose dolphin popped up right here next to the railing? What would you do?
Well, I would use my super duper extra strength. Specially formulated triple G antibacterial spray called Germain's Germs Gone.
Well, that might work for a bottlenose dolphin, but what if a sperm whale surfaced next to the ship near where you're standing right now?
Well, I would go below.
Smart, to be safe. Right?
No, to use my spray bottle and to refill it.
Oh.
Well, well, well. My hunka 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 burning love. I have a question for you.
Shoot.
What if this gorgeous mermaid jumped out of the sea and landed right at your feet? What would you do?
A mermaid? Oh. Why, the poor thing, I'd pick her up.
With your bare hands? And you wouldn't use gloves or spray anything?
You betcha. And you can forget about your sanitary wipes, too. Come on, honey.
The prominent decks is just beautiful. And did you happen to see that gorgeous tall drink of water who just passed by here a few minutes ago?
You mean the one that looks like he has a full head of wavy hair and his own teeth?
That's the one.
Well, does that mean that you're getting thirsty enough to have a sip?
I didn't see anyone matching that description.
Well, you could probably see better if you put on your glasses.
Well, I can't find my glasses. Wait a minute. Let me check.
Oh, you've already got lipstick on. Put it back. Oh, you cannot drive your car on the ship, baby. No.
Yeah.
Whew, we're seeing a lot up here. Oh, remind me never to ask you for a Kleenex.
I don't know.
Oh, that's your ID, honey, and you might need it before we get off this ship.
I don't know. No glasses in there?
Well, I think you could try looking on top of your head.
Oh! There they are! Well,
ladies, I think it's about time for lunch. What do you say we mosey over to the buffet and check out the food?
Oh, and maybe that tall drink of water.
Ready. You may start the music. To practice the second verse. I must preserve my voice for my performance. Allez.
I can never get used to the ship's stabilizers. They do anything but stabilize my stomach. The deck feels like it's swaying from side to side.
Well, it looks like you have some bandages. What happened?
Oh, I got this rope climbing. No big deal.
Well, there must be something tamer you can try. Oh, let's say cooking class?
That's where I burnt my eyebrows off.
Oh, boy. Well, how about ping pong?
Yeah, I got hit in the eye. Thus, the eye patch.
Oh. Well, there must be something you can do that you're not going to get hurt.
Well, I'm on my way to zip lining course.
You might. Did you sign your waiver?
Oh, yes, yes. Oh, I got a ping on my my luggage. It is in Antarctica. Bags are getting around more than I am.
Well, slap my head and call me silly, but I heard a lot of passengers on this ship have seen Elvis already. Have you seen him yet?
Heavens to Betsy, no, I ain't seen him yet. And you know, we lived in Memphis at the same time.
We did.
I ain't never seen him there either.
Me either.
Maybe he be in the casino after dinner, you think?
Maybe.
Hey, maybe we'll see Mary Sue there too.
Oh, maybe we will.
If it was her.
Oh, it's getting hot out here, isn't it?
I know. I'm just sweating like a hooker in church. Let's go on inside.
Wow. I never knew that you could have as many servings of tiramisu as you want on a ship. Oh, man. That man at our table, he had 10 desserts for lunch.
His wife is not going to be happy later tonight when that tiramisu comes back to revisit him.
No.
But did you see who was at the next table from us? Our Mr. Tall Drink of Water. I hope we run into him later.
Well, he smiled at me.
Oh, you wish.
I think he was looking for a waiter.
That could be.
But I forgot to tell you, I met him. Yes, what? He came right up to me and he said, "It's so nice to see you again." And I asked him, when did he see me? And he said, "Last night in my dreams."
Oh, brother.
you know, ladies, I don't think he's all that good looking.
I think you forgot to put on your glasses again.
Oh.
Nope.
No. Yeah. There they are.
Oh, yes, now.
Oh, what should we do next?
Oh, yeah. You know what I think? I think I'd like to go visit the gift shop.
Oh, that would be good.
And why don't we just meet up later?
Oh, that would
That's
be good.
A great idea. Who knows who I might run into again?
Oh, for me.
Hey there. Hi. Oh, no, no. No, no. Say, how was the buffet? The missus and I are thinking about checking it out tonight.
Yes, and are they using the proper sneeze guards? And is the crew making sure that the passengers are not touching and breathing on the food? Is it safe?
I don't know about the sneeze guards, and I'm not sure if they're keeping up with all the drips and drizzles, but the food looks good, and boy, is it delicious.
Did you say drips? Drizzle? Fine. That doesn't sound fine to me.
This, it's anarchy. This is no way to run a ship. We must speak to the captain.
There he is.
Inadvisable. this happened, but the captain asked me to give you these invitations to his cocktail hour.
Nice.
He must have been under the influence of his seasickness medicine, rendering him... Blah! But, anywho. The captain is expecting you, so please dress accordingly.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Now, what are you going to wear? What are you going to wear?
I don't know, Franny Lou. How about if I wear that skin-tight, sparkly jumpsuit that shows off my boobs and my butt?
Oh, yeah.
But I forgot to pack it.
Oh, no. What are you going to wear?
Okay,
then?
How about the leopard prints?
Yeah.
Everyone will be seeing spots when I walk through the room. I still can strut that way, show off my long legs.
Oh, absolutely. And what are you going to wear on your feet?
Oh, my pink Crocs. I never travel without them.
Oh, yes. Well, I'm going to wear my peacock printed skirt.
Ooh.
And my gold belt.
Yep.
And my green sparkly top and my fuchsia hat with the red goose feathers.
Oh, yes.
And guess what? I took some old black tennis shoes and I put sequins all over them.
Ooh, you be shining.
I know. We're just going to be looking so great.
Ah! Oh, you two cannot be serious. Cocktails with the captain is an elegant affair.
Yeah.
Formal wear is a must.
Uh-huh.
Your outfits might work for the grand old opry or whatever you want to call it, but they aren't appropriate for the captain's cocktail party.
Well, I declare.
Well, we're going to that shindig come hell or high water.
Yep. Well, the ship does rent clothing in the gift shop, and I suggest the two of you march off in that direction, and I mean now, because it's going to take you some time and a lot of help to find the correct attire.
I just love that word, attire.
Well, honey, we better go this way then. And put on our nice clothes.
Wait, you bet.
Wait,
you bet.
Lady.
Bye.
Oh, well, good luck to the two of you. You're gonna need it.
I'm so sorry.
Can you believe it? The captain's cocktail party.
Oh my gosh, our friends back home will never believe this. And boy, oh boy, are they going to be jealous. Drinking with El Capitan.
Yes. Oh, but I don't know how to speak Spanish. Does that mean I can't come with you?
Of course you can come. I was just trying to be continental.
Oh. Okay.
You know, I knew it was right to bring my accessories and my fancy schmancy dresses. But so many choices.
Yeah, that's true.
What to wear? Well, one thing's for certain. I'm going to wear the silver-plated tiara Mr. Drink gave me on our last encounter. He whispered into my ear, "You are my queen. And he will be my king."
Oh, for heaven's sakes. Well, I have the perfect outfit to wear, and all eyes will be on me. And if we're going through the glaciers at that moment, I will generate so much heat, they will melt. And by the way, Mr. Tall Drink of Water gave me a fabulous real cubic zirconia ring. And it'll be on my hand for all to see me sparkle.
Oh, gosh.
Well, Mr. Drink gave me a nickel-plated lighter. And you see? And he said it was to remind me that I'm hot.
Oh, fiddlesticks.
Yes, really. But I don't smoke, and I have no idea what I'm going to do with it. I don't know. And I don't know what I'm going to wear either, but one thing's a must, and that's my white gloves. They've been handed down from my family for generations. From generation to generation, and of course they have a few holes in them now.
Oh well, let's go find some new gloves.
Go get dressed. Come on, let's go get dressed.
am here. You may now begin. However, I only ever eat frog legs still attached to the frog. I must preserve my voice. I cannot eat it this time. Ellie.
I knew I heard Mary Sue's voice, didn't I?
You know, it sure did look like her, and if it wasn't her, it was her long-lost twin sister.
Well, wouldn't that be a hoot and a holler?
It sure would.
Good evening, fellow sea wanderers.
Good gosh almighty! How'd you get so battered and bruised?
I am so glad you asked. I was having fun. Rock climbing, zip lining, darts, a shuffleboard, darts, cooking class, ping pong, and I'm not even halfway through with my list. Oh no. Oh, and I got an update on my phone for my luggage. Okay. And guess what? It's now in the Bermuda Triangle.
Well, your suitcase is. It's getting closer. So that should make you happier than a turkey the day after Thanksgiving. Sure.
You know, I think you ought to pull up a chair and have a seat before you break something else.
Well, you look happier than an ant in a sugar bowl, you know, but I hope you can get to the end of that list and the end of this cruise in one piece.
Oh, yes. What an absolutely delightful afternoon. Oh, is it hot in here?
I'll say, scorching.
Yes, it is. Say, Gretchen, didn't you say you were going to the gift shop? Did you find anything very interesting?
Oh, yeah, I did. Actually, I did find something. I found this lovely skull.
Oh, that is pretty.
Oh, that is beautiful.
What else? What else?
Really?
Because I haven't met it.
Oh,
you got something for me?
I did.
Just for me?
Yes. it's the cutest thing. Just the darlingest little hat that you ever saw. Okay. And that is all I found interesting today.
Well, you're right about that. We have a toast and drink to a hot cha-cha-cha cruise.
That's a great idea.
Waiter, champagne, please.
He does not look good at all.
Kim, you take over.
Oh, no.
Good evening. Unfortunately, Captain Bill will be unable to join us for cocktails. He's feeling a bit under the weather, but I'm here, and I'd be glad to answer any of your questions.
Yeah, okay. Does line dancing start? And do you need a partner in line dancing?
I am very sorry to have to tell you that we had to cancel Madame Fufu's concert this evening.
Oh.
whom musicians all became violently ill. Now, as we promised, the Passengers Talent Show will begin. Let us give a big hand to the cruise director.
Oh, my goodness.
Never knew the cruise director was so talented. And now, let's welcome Jerry and Jenny Jermy.
That's Jermaine, not Jermy.
Look, let's be honest. Betwixt me and the missus, we ain't got one scintilla of talent. But we know what to do with a captive audience. So we've come up with a little ditty to help remind you that germs are everywhere. Are you ready, Jen? Here we go. Hit it. We were born to sanitize.
We were born to sanitize.
Germ bacteria don't matter the size.
Germs bacteria no matter the size.
Put your gloves on every day.
Put your gloves on every day.
And spritz, spritz, spritz those germs away.
And spritz, spritz, spritz those germs away.
Sound off.
Sound off.
Sound off.
Sound off.
One, two, three, four. Germ-free. Don't touch crap with your bare hands.
Don't touch crap with your bare hands.
Spritz, spritz, spritz when you're opening cans.
Spritz, spritz, spritz when you're opening cans.
Always spritz when in doubt.
Always spritz when in doubt.
And you will wipe those germs right out.
And you will wipe those germs right out.
Sound off.
Sound off.
Sound off.
Sound off.
One, two, three, four. Germ-free. There are no germs that are safe from us.
That doesn't rhyme.
Sorry.
Oh, I got it in my mouth.
Oh, it's in my eye. It's in my eye. Blood.
Unsanitized.
I wouldn't. Out.
We were only trying to help.
Our next act is Ms. Gates, Ms. Fox, and Ms. Sills.
Well, we've been friends for close to 50 years, and this song will explain why. If you're ever in a jam, here I am.
If you're ever in a mess, S-O-S.
If you ever get so happy you land in jail, I'm your bail.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgotten, ours will still be hot. La-di-da-di-da-di-ding-ding-ding.
If ever up a tree phone to me.
If you're ever down a well, ring my bell.
If you ever lose your teeth when you're out to dine, borrow mine.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect blendship, when other friendships have been forgate, ours will still be great. La-di-da-di-da-di-cha-cha-cha.
You ever lose your mind, I'll be kind.
If you ever lose your shirt, I'll be hurt.
If you're ever at a mill and get sawed in half, I won't laugh.
That's friendship, friendship, just the perfect blendship. When other friendships have been forget, ours will still be in. La-di-da-di-da-di, hep, hep, hep.
And now, introducing Claude Malandroit.
My turn!
Oh, wow! You know, as a long time ago, I was told something very important. Growing old may be mandatory, but growing up is optional. Oh, and I got an update on my phone. It's right now floating in, it's floating around the Area 51. Now for my act. Now, does anybody have a light?
Oh, yeah.
No.
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 Well, that was really interesting. And now, straight from a passing barge, y'all see the barge? The Fort Collins Senior Serenaders. Let's give them a big hand. There, I see another barge. So let's welcome to sing a lovely song, Drew Gardner. Give her a big hand.
me, baby, to recognize me. Well, it's been a year, it doesn't surprise me. I wrapped it up and sent it with a note saying I love you, I meant it. Now I know what a fool I've been, but if you kiss me now, I know you'll fool me again. Last Christmas I gave you my heart, but the very next day you gave it away. This year, the seven frontiers, I'll give it to someone special. So I keep my distance from you, and you stole our hearts. My God, I thought you were someone to rely on me. I guess I was a shoulder to cry on. Give it to someone special. A man undercover with a fire in his heart, a face of a lover, but you tore him apart. Now I found real love, you'll never fool me again. Last Christmas I gave you my heart, but the very next day you gave it. Save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. I gave you my heart, the very next day you gave it away. This year, save me from tears, I'll give it to someone, I'll give it to someone special. Special
for our last performer, our last passenger performer, please give a hand for Jane Plainfield.
Santa baby, just slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an angel all year, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, a 54 convertible to light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Think of all the fun I've missed. Think of all the fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year I could be just as good if you'll check off my Christmas list. Santa baby, I want a yacht, and really that's not a lot. Been
an angel all year, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa honey, there's one thing that I really do need, the deed to a platinum mine. Santa honey, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Oh, Santa cutie, and fill my stocking with the duplex and checks. Sign your X on the line, Santa cutie, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany's. I really do believe in you. Let's see if you believe in me. Santa baby, forgot to mention one little thing, a ring. I don't mean on the phone, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry down the chimney tonight. Oh, hurry tonight.
There's a lot of talented people on this ship.
Sure are.
Whatever happened to my part? It was exciting at the start. Now we're halfway through Act Two, and I've had nothing yet to do. I've been off stage for far too long. It's ages since I had a song. This is one unhappy diva. The producers have deceived her. There is nothing I can sing from my heart. Whatever happened to my part? I am sick of my career, always stuck in second gear, up to here with frustration and with fear. I've no Grammys, no rewards, I've no Tony Awards. I'm constantly replaced by Britney Spears. Britney Spears! Whatever happened to my show? I was a hit, now I don't know. I'm with a bunch of crazy nuts, prancing round in loud plaid shorts. I might as well go to the bar. I can't escape, we're out too far. Too far to get away. Well, I can last for one more day, but it seems to me they've really lost the plot. Whatever happened to my...
I'll call my agent, damn it.
Whatever happened to my...
Not yours, and definitely not yours, but mine.
something spectacular last night. Oh, never mind. Get me a café au lait and some beignets.
Oh, yummy coffee and donuts. Okay.
Oh, my.
I had the most wonderful night last night. What about you, Jim?
I didn't get to say goodnight to you two because it seems we got separated.
Oh, we did get separated. Yes, we did.
Yes, we did.
It was beyond my wildest dreams.
So, what did
you hear? What about you?
What happened, that's right. You know, last night I kept hearing a lot of noise.
What?
From your stateroom. Yes, from your stateroom. After 11:30, it was so noisy.
That's really funny because Linda, at midnight, I heard a lot of noise coming from your room. What were you up to, girl? Dish.
Well, if you must know, I had a visitor. Mr.
You.
Tall Drink of Water.
What do you mean? He brought me back to my stateroom at 11.
What? Wait a minute, he visited my room at 11:30.
What? Oh, ladies. It sounds like we all got our thirst quenched last night.
Oh, what do you mean? What do you mean? He didn't.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. He played us all. But you know what? I don't really mind because I had fun.
Oh, me too. Me three.
And the important thing is, we didn't let him ruin our friendship.
That's right. We've been friends way too long to let that happen.
Yeah. Yes. And
friendship. Just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgotten.
I knew that was you. I told you.
Ellie Mae, you and Franny Lou are gonna ruin my persona.
What?
Nobody believes a girl from the country can sing opera unless it's Grand Ole Opry. So please play along with me.
Okay, I get it. Madame Foo-Foo, you are just the most amazing Opry singer. Oh, what a wonderful voice.
Merci, my good women. You are bienvenue. Now, I must be on my way.
Thanks, girls. Can you believe that?
She's sure living high on the hog. She's such a great diva.
Un rire qui se perd sous sa bouche.
Beware, we're coming into high winds and rough waters. Please use extra caution when you're out on the decks. Warning, warning.
Wow, talk about riding the storm out. This is definitely going on my bucket list before I grow old.
Bucket list? This shouldn't go on anybody's bucket list. But maybe a mermaid will come on board, Hoppy.
Huh? I'm looking for some mermaids.
This is some storm.
Oh, sure. Oh. Some of this.
I'm so glad we have each other to hold on to, but I'm even more glad I have this hat.
Oh, look, them waves sure are pitching a hissy fit. Whoa, wee, this storm came up faster than green grass through a goose.
Hey, ladies, any mermaids nearby?
Or mermaids?
I don't see no mermaids or merman.
Hey, my app says my luggage is there on that pier.
What? Can't be. Oh, yeah, okay.
Warning. Warning, unfortunately, the pier that we were to dock at has washed away.
No.
We are headed back out to sea to ride out the storm indefinitely.
Oh, no. Great, indefinitely. Now I can try some wakeboarding.
Oh, sure.
Are you kidding me?
There goes the pier. Uh-oh, Claude, there goes your luggage.
Oh.
Oh. Are you kidding me?
Oh.
That's it. I can't take any more. Kim, you're in charge.
Oh,
take
no.
over.
No, Captain.
No.
Finally! Just call me Captain Kim. You know what we're going to do now? We're going to have us a sing-along because it's the holidays.
All right. Yeah, that works. Okay. Okay. Wait.
Just thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree won't be the same here if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes start
Christmas, happy Hanukkah, happy Kwanzaa, and a joyful winter solstice to all of you. Feliz Navidad.
Happy holidays to all, and to all a good